Next video will be the next installment for the Rum Rebellion, and we're up to Thursday, 24th of December. Christmas Eve. After breakfast, my aunt announced that today we had to gather in some blossoming trees to decorate for the festive season. These trees are so different and it does not feel like Christmas. Indeed, how could it possibly feel like Christmas when there is no snow, no icy wind, no pond for skating, no smell of coal fires and chestnuts roasting, and, instead of wearing my thickest, warmest clothing, I am here only in a light shirt and trousers. My feet are bare and still I am not cold. We went out early to avoid the heat of the day. Uncle George took his vegetables to sell in Parramatta. He was agitated at breakfast and said that now was the time for all men to stand firm. It sounded heroic and dramatic, and I thought of his friend's words about freeborn Englishmen and soldiers. It is like the book of heroes that my mother read me when I was little and which I could not bring with me. Maybe he is like Robert the Bruce or William Wallace or even like the brave King Arthur. Aunt Sarah asked him not to be so theatrical in front of the children. He said the children must know the history being created in their own land, but I do not know what he was talking about. He said it would all become clear later on and left without saying more. Aunt Sarah led us in procession to the banks of the creek and we walked along, finding a lot of young trees, their branches heavy with red leaves. There were others where bursts of white and yellow flowers dragged the branches almost to the ground. I had never seen such a sight before. After we had rested a while, my aunt took a strong knife and hacked at the stems until the branches came free. Each of us took up what we could carry. Even Sarah, who is barely able to walk, toddled along, trailing her branch of Christmas bush. When we got home, we made large bunches of different colours and tied them to stakes driven into the ground outside the door. One day Aunt Sarah says there will be a roof over these stakes, and then we will sit there in the cool in the heat of the day instead of having to stay inside or rest under the shade of the kitchen tree. In the afternoon, the children were put down to sleep in their parents' bed in the second room, and while they slept, my aunt and Ellen baked for tomorrow. They asked me if I wished to help, and I wanted to say no, but they tempted me with things to eat and said the sun outside was hotter than the blacksmith's forge when he was shaping a wheel. They were laughing and joking, and sometimes they invited me to comment on their stories, but I said nothing. I think I blushed whenever my name was mentioned. I carried the bags of flour from the store shed and drew water from the well. I sat quietly at the table sorting out dried fruits for the cake and pies, finding tiny stones that had been added to the bags to make the weight, but which break a tooth as quick as winking. I confessed to having taken a piece of orange peel and also of dried cherry and sucked the sweetness from them. I can say that here, for no one will ever read this. Why is it that I can say things here in this logbook that I could never imagine declaring out loud? Why does my tongue falter and my courage disappear when I go to speak? And that ends that installment of the Rum Rebellion.